Shabbat Shalom, everyone. This week's portion is B'Shalach, and the Jewish people are free from Egypt, and they are going to the land of Israel. And God says in the beginning of the portion, I shall not take them on the short route through the coast, but I shall take them through the desert, coming from the east into the west, into the land of Israel. And the question is why? Why not take the short route? And the commentators are saying already that in order for them to come out of the mentality of slavery, they have to wander in the desert. It's easy to take the Jewish people out of Egypt. It's more difficult to take Egypt and the mentality of slavery out of the Jewish people. But there's another profound commentator or commentary by the Abarbanel, a 15th century commentator from Spain. And he says something very unique. He says that when you notice in the Bible that when God says to Pharaoh, when Moses says to Pharaoh, let my people go, it is always accompanied by, so they shall worship me in the desert. Not only let my people go forever, but always so they shall worship me in the desert. Therefore, when Pharaoh releases the Jewish people, he's under the false pretense that they're going to worship God in the desert and they're going to come back. So therefore, when God tells Moses to release them out of the slavery in Egypt, he does not take them straight to Israel. He says, promises we have to keep. And therefore, we're going to worship God in the desert. Only when Pharaoh breaks his promise and chases after the Jewish people in the Sea of Reeds, that's when the promises broke and God can lead them into the Jewish homeland, into the land of Israel. Same thing happens to Moses and the golden calf. When God wants to destroy the people, Moses pleads and says to them, what are the Egyptians going to say? You took them out of Egypt in order to destroy them? And God says, you know what, you're right. And he does not destroy the Jewish people. There's a strong message here that promises have to be kept. Even against the greatest tyrant, against the greatest dictatorship like Pharaoh that wanted to destroy the Jewish people, but still a promise to Pharaoh is a promise to Pharaoh. And what will the people say if God goes back on his promise? His name will be carried in vain. And therefore, a promise should be something that is always kept, even with the greatest of tyrants, with the greatest of dictators like Pharaoh. So this is the home take value. The end does not justify the means. And even if you have to leave and escape, you still have to stick to what you're promised. What a strong message for this week's portion. Vayhi b'shalach paro. When Pharaoh let the people go under a certain pretense, you cannot go back on your word, even for a person like Pharaoh. Shabbat Shalom.